Obi-Wan Kenobi, one of the finest examples of a Jedi Master, and an individual who not only shaped the galaxy for the better, but in many ways saved it outright. But every warrior has their trials and their first battles. Today, we will explore how Obi-Wan Kenobi became a Jedi and his history before doing so, as well as how he failed his Jedi trials. Obi-Wan was born on the planet of Stujon to a family who had amassed a fairly sizable fortune. Obi-Wan, as a very young child, was brought to the Jedi Temple after his family discovered that he was powerful in the Force, but not exceptionally so. Obi-Wan would later recall what he believed was a memory playing with his younger brother named Owen, but it was later revealed the child he saw was Owen Lars, although their paths had not yet crossed. Obi-Wan seeing Owen was actually a vision granted to him through the Force, the same Owen that in fact would later raise Luke Skywalker, son of Anakin Skywalker. As a Jedi learner, Kenobi advanced with his skills, although he was not as powerful as many of the other students. Kenobi at times could be overconfident, and this would lead into anger. Under Jedi Master Yoda, however, Kenobi was able to overcome many of these hindrances. Despite his advancements though, no Jedi Master arrived to claim Obi-Wan Kenobi as an apprentice. At the age of 12, Kenobi had still not been selected by a master to train him, as although his skill was notable, it was often viewed as subpar. Obi-Wan was powerful and skilled, but not as much as was required for a Jedi Padawan. Because of this, Obi-Wan began to lose hope of ever becoming a Jedi, fearful he would be forced to fall into another role to serve the Order, but never truly become a Knight. One day, the Jedi Master Qui-Gon Jinn witnessed Kenobi spar with another Jedi learner, and admired him for his persistence, but noted he was uncontrolled, and did not match the skill necessary to become a Padawan. This was unfortunately the final straw, and Obi-Wan was sent away from Coruscant and the Jedi Temple to aid the Republic and Jedi in a different way. Kenobi's new job was to collect crops to help feed the Jedi at the Temple and within the Jedi Order, and while doing so, he again crossed paths with Qui-Gon Jinn. Here, Qui-Gon's former Jedi apprentice, Xanatos, attacked the Jedi Master, revealing Qui-Gon being called away from the Temple was a trap. However, because of Obi-Wan, the Jedi Master was saved, and Obi-Wan displayed his true potential as a Jedi. Following this, Jinn brought Kenobi back to the Jedi Temple, and took him on as his full-time apprentice. This would not be the end for the trials of Obi-Wan though. At first, Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan were not a good fit, as although Kenobi could be slightly arrogant, he always strictly followed the commands of the larger Jedi Order. Jinn, on the other hand, was more of a rogue, notorious for bending the beliefs of the Jedi and rules as well. It was because of this core difference that the two of them constantly butted heads. However, over time, their differences began to benefit them as they complemented each other. Through training from both Qui-Gon Jinn as well as Yoda, Obi-Wan would eventually become a Jedi Knight. However, Jinn would never live to see this. Obi-Wan would always hold a close place for Qui-Gon Jinn within his heart though, as if it wasn't for the Jedi Master, Obi-Wan would never have become a Jedi himself, and have been given another opportunity to prove himself. But that is how Obi-Wan Kenobi became a Jedi, and how he initially failed his Jedi trials and was not selected as a Jedi Padawan. But leave your thoughts on this in the comments down below, and that Obi-Wan was at first not selected by a Jedi Master to be trained full time. Did you know this about the famous Jedi Master, and if so, what do you think about this in the Star Wars lore?